Students, welcome back to computer applications classes of class 10. Hope all of you are doing well. Let us see what are the things that we are going to learn in HTML today. So today we will be learning internal linking and try to understand what is the difference between the internal linking and external linking. As all of you know, we have already covered external linking in our previous session. So let us see first what is internal linking. Internal linking is nothing but it is a link within the same web page or same website. This link can be absolute and relative path. As you all know, what is absolute path and relative path? Now, HTML internal linking name is followed by the hash sign tag, and you have to assign an ID to refer section of your web page, which is referred to as internal link to the same page. And the attributes used for internal linking is ID and name. Yeah, obviously href is also one of the attributes. Now when you click on the internal anchor link, you will scroll automatically to the referred section and display it on your browser. Let us take an example. I'll just tell you once. Suppose you have got one suppose this is your web page, your HTML attributes, and in down the web page there is again attributes written and there is explanation of the attributes. Okay, the moment you click attributes, you will be taken to the section of attribute of the same web page. You do not have to scroll down with yourself. You will be taken to there automatically. So scrolling will be done with the help of the web page only. You don't have to do on your own. So this is basically internal linking. So you can find this thing in your Wikipedia and like that. Just see, we have got an example. Like I have got this screenshot wherein if you will get history of Wikipedia, if you search it, you will find this content. You can see this, where background, formulation of concept and foundation, these are the links. So when we click on background, are we taken to another web page? No. When we click on the background, we will be taken to the background section of that web page. It is the same page. Okay, this is the same page. It just the moment you click on background or formulation of the concept, you will be taken to that particular section. So that is the use of internal linking. Whereas external linking, you will be taken from one website to another website. Okay, means the domain will be different. Now let us see how we will write the code in a brief manner. These are the basic code that is required, and then we will learn the whole HTML code for internal linking. These are the basic lines. Like we have to write ahref hashtag lesson 1 and then lesson 1. Lesson.1, this is just the portion, that this is the hypertext, and this is the main thing. Suppose you want to have this one, you want to have this ID is equal to lesson 1. Just see, we have taken a section hashtag lesson 1. We do not have to write lesson1.html since we are not taking it to another page, another website. Okay, it is the same web page, so we have to just mention the we have to just mention the specific section. Okay, so that's why we have first where we are putting it in href. So href is equal to hashtag. With the hashtag only we have to mention. Without hashtag you cannot work. So hashtag lesson 1 and then Whenever we are having the next section, we will write AID is equal to lesson 1, introduction lesson 1. Okay. So, one more thing. As we all know that name and ID are both the attributes, but ID is the most preferable attribute to be used, because name attribute is not supported by HTML5, which is actually nowadays used in all of the web pages. Now let us see an example. Now when, just see over here, we have first mentioned all the links like AHREF hashtag lesson 1, then AHREF hashtag lesson 2, AHREF hashtag lesson 3, AHREF hashtag lesson 4. Now we will mention these sections. How? Suppose the first section for lesson 1, we will write AID equal to lesson 1. Since we have written over here hashtag lesson 1, that's why ID equal to lesson 1. Okay? Then introduction to lesson, whatever you want to have as lesson 1. And these are the basically the body of that portion. Then again, the next section. Here, the next portion ID is equal to, so div ID we have written over here. This is the next section. You can also write AID, no issues. Then again, next, another paragraph. So PID, and if you want to have it as an article, so you can write, or simply you can just write AID, AID and AID. Okay. So when you will run this, how you will get the code? Here. The moment you will run it, you'll find this. Actually, I was not having a single web page. Means it's not possible to show you the whole web page. So what I have done, I have taken the screenshots and put them in such a manner. Like this is actually this is the first portion and this is the next portion of the same web page. So this is actually the continuation. Okay, so whenever, if suppose I have clicked lesson flow, this lesson 4, if I click, then I'll, my cursor will be taken to this area. If I click to lesson 2, my cursor will be taken to this area. I hope you are understanding what is internal linking. And even if you are having any doubt, you can always ask. So, this is your internal linking. So, I hope you have also understood what is the difference between internal linking and external linking. Thank you for today. And if you have any doubt, you can always ask the questions. We'll explain it. Thank you.